Hello!
Welcome.
It's my patch.
What are we doing?
Now, did a beer mail with a good friend of ours, Amanda Hunt. She manages to get us beers that we can't get, and we get her beers that she can't get.
Mm.
And she got us this Imperial Stout from Fuller's. Comes in a nice old cardboard box. Just take a picture. So I can, before we crack it open, because I did want to take the picture in case I damaged the box. But yeah, it was a gift from Amanda Hunt in BML. Do you want to read the box while taking pictures?
Right, this is specially handcrafted from the traditional recipe, going at 10.7%. It's a limited edition. It's a traditional style that became favourite for the Russian royal court. This is a limited edition Imperial Stout. Has been specially created as a single brew. It is a unique addition to this historic recipe. The floral character of Centennial hops is enhanced by the inclusion of the rosebuds, lending a hint of Turkish delight and the flavour to the beer. Excuse me. This Imperial Stout has a rich, dark appearance with strong chocolate and deep cherry notes, which leads to a light, bitter finish. Being a bottle condition, this beer will form a natural sediment, so pour carefully in your mini.
Yeah, the only problem with this beer, you can age it till 2023.
As the Ed Brewer signature as well.
John Keeling. Slight smokiness there. A little bit of hazelnuts, a bit of campfire almost.
I get a lot of chocolate there.
Ooh, milky chocolate.
Mm.
So far,
reminded you of the best guest from last night.
Oh yeah, we had a local brewery out of York, Brass Castle and the Bad Kitty. Very nice. It wasn't to the IABV of this, but it was really sessionable.
Yeah.
Anyway. Pouring slightly thin, a little bit of reddish brown there.
Almost the sound of it, you're pouring like a liquor.
Oh. Not getting as much chocolate on the... It's not as milky compared to the two.
You get more on the bottle.
Because it smells like a chocolate liqueur on the bowl.
It smells like that fruits on the glass though. Like dark fruits, almost like yeah.
We just had the Old World Russian Imperial. That was a little bit of alcohol in the smell. You're not getting no alcohol on the rum on this.
Mm.
Ooh, I'm getting the chocolate now.
I'm getting a lot of dark roasting now. Mmm. It sort of invigorates all your palate at once.
It's almost like goth colour, isn't it? But I think a lot of the olden days, they used to have like a really beautiful purple in their colours.
I don't know where
royalty.
It comes off with a sort of almost a vintage taste, you know what I mean?
I'm not getting alcohol.
Like something that's been aged, you know what I mean? But
this is 10%. That's higher ABV than the Brewdog we just had. And I've got more alcohol taste in that than I did with this.
With this one,
this is just like the Brass Castle one we had. It's just, but it's 10%.
Well, I think what I'm getting with this, a full flavour there coming through, of almost like chocolate currants, you know, like those chocolate raisins.
Oh, yeah, it's like a raisin that's covered in chocolate.
Yeah, that's the one, yeah. stuff like that. I'm getting that sort of flavour. So almost maybe rum. I don't know. Is it rum or not quite rum?
No, it almost like wooden barrel smell.
Yeah, you get like a vintage oak aged beer taste. You know what I mean?
A little shit. It's just because we had it a while. I think it was York Beer Festival last year.
To be honest, like it says on the bottle, right? That what it said, a deep cherry note. Now maybe you get that because it's like maybe because it might be cherry oak.
Maybe. It's a little fizz on the palate there, but you're not getting alcohol. I'm guessing it will. Now we've decanted it, it'll probably as it warms it'll.
Yeah, blows that off.
But as it sounds right now, the edge tension is a little poor. And would I buy it again? I don't think I would if I had the choice of buying it. I mean, when I saw this, I went, oh, an Imperial Stout, found it from Fuller's. But
would you edge it, or?
I don't know.
It's on the border of possible.
I mean, I loved the way they've gone with the bottle, with the purples and the blacks and the golds. Mm. It's really beautiful. But there's not much on the aroma, there's not much on the taste. It's, I don't know if it'll improve. If it does, we'll come back. If it doesn't, no.
Like I say, you're probably not getting the alcohol.
No.
You get a full flavour there.
It tastes really nice. But I'm not getting a 10%, so I'm feeling like I've lost out, and it's not. I'm going to be like blah 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 blah.
I mean, I don't know. I don't really get almost a slight coffee note there, like almost like cafe creme. You know what I mean, like that. What is it? Cafe creme camp or something.
Yeah. Oh yeah, yeah.
Like a coffee liqueur.
It's like an extract that you add to the coffee.
Yeah.
I think it's called Campofino or something. Campo.
Camp.
Yeah. So it's something with camp in it.
Yeah.
It's slowly coming out. It's more woody and a little bit of chocolate. It's nice. It's all right. But it's like you're getting all this prestige of a box. You get this prestige of a beautifully crafted bottle and label, and then you get this, and it's just like.
I thought the beer tastes nice.
Yeah, it tastes nice. It's just like you're getting given this. You go, that's so pretty. So pretty. And then you pull it out, and you go, oh. The colours, it's like you're feeling like you're going to open something really impressive.
Yeah.
And then you drink it, it's like, It just doesn't live up to the all that finesse and artwork. We had that before with some of the beers, didn't we? It's like all that beer that it was a really tasty beer, but the artwork was really poor.
But I like the taste. You know what I mean? But
yeah, it's really nice. It's nice. I mean,
how much would you recommend?
It's a stout from Fuller's. You don't see that many stouts from Fuller's, so I'd see it, buy it, but I won't go out of my way to buy it now I've had it. It's basically add it, tick it, next beer. But other than that,
yeah, I mean, I'm liking the taste. I mean, yeah. it's not bad.
We've had a lot of 10% Imperial Stouts.
Yeah.
Would it go up there with some of those that you've had, like the Great Divide? Yeah.
I'm bored of it, you know what I mean? Sort of not right up there, you know what I mean? But
I'd probably put it in the top 40, probably, as in Imperial Stouts.
Yeah.
I won't put it in top 30, but it'd probably be up there in the top 40.
I mean, I've had worse Imperial Stouts than this.
Oh, we've had some terrible ones.
Yeah.
It comes with the job. You take care.
Goodbye.